Hey everybody, welcome back to Magic Orthodoxy. My name is David, and this is a Magic Review. Hey, welcome back. Thanks for spending some time with me. Thanks for being here. If you're new to the channel, this is what I do. I review magic tricks, I review decks of cards, and I also do giveaways. Doing a huge Christmas giveaway this month. Every single Friday, I'm giving something massive away to one lucky person. So make sure you hit like and subscribe. Make sure you hit all your notifications so that you are aware when those go live. Today, we got a really cool review for you. This is The Gaff System by Lloyd Barnes. All right, The Gaff System. Now, you're probably already familiar with Illusionist. They've put out some other titles very similar to this. Way back when, there was Ultra Gaff, right? Ultra Gaff, I got that, did a review for it. It has kind of like become the grandfather of trick Gaff decks that also included a huge video tutorial. I remember when Ultra Gaff came out, it was two DVDs. You're like, two DVDs? And, you know, it's like, wow. And since then, Daniel Madison had his Gambler's release. It was a deck of cards, and then he released two DVDs, right? A whole DVD of Gaff tricks, and then he had a whole DVD of like Gaff theory, where he interviewed like all these different magicians, and it was a phenomenal project. Then we had the Gaff system. There was a Gaff system that Madison and Jones and Morelli put out, and it was also very similar, again, Gaff deck, and then some DVDs. And so what Lloyd Barnes has done is he's kind of like taken all of that history of working with Illusionist and then married it into his version. This is his interpretation. You know, if you followed Lloyd Barnes on Instagram for any amount of time, you see that he's very familiar with Gaff tricks, social media tricks, doing this little pieces of impossibility on video. And what he's done is he's just taken that lifetime of work and then shrunk it down into, you know, what he could put in a deck of 52 cards and just a ton of tricks. And so we are going to get into it right now. Now, while it's true that a lot of magic products get sent to me for free, this product I actually paid for with my own money, but it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter, because at the end of the day, I always have to be honest with you and I always have to be factual with you so that you understand fully what you get with your money, because I know you are spending your hard-earned money and I want to make sure that you get all the answers so that you can spend your money wisely. So to give you honest and factual reviews, I always ask the same questions. I ask the same exact questions. My format is very simple. And the first question is, what do you get? You spend your money, it comes to you in the mail, you open it up, what do you get? You get this really cool box. It's got Lloyd's signature on the flap there. And then inside the box, you're getting two decks. You're getting the fully custom Gaff deck, and you'll know it's the Gaff deck because it has Lloyd's signature. And you get a just plain everyday deck of cohorts, which is nice because then you can start doing tricks right away. If you don't already have a deck, buy one because you're gonna want extra cards, right? You're gonna want extra cards. So make sure you buy up some red cohorts so that you can have a little Gaff system. Also, when you buy it, you should get a notification in your email or maybe in your Illusionist profile that gives you access to the Magic Stream videos. All right, so what's the overall quality and production value of the videos? The videos are pretty much Lloyd seated, and he's talking to a mounted stationary camera. I don't believe he has a cameraman for any of this, so there's no tracking, there's no camera tracking. He's either gonna move things to the camera or away from the camera depending on what he wants you to see, and then it's all edited together. He's in a living room setting. He's mostly using a couch and a coffee table when he needs it. There is some light music in the background, but it doesn't get in the way. And the other thing that I should mention, and I'll just put it in this spot here, is that you don't really need a spectator for any of these effects. You know, when Lloyd does his tricks, he's doing them on Instagram, he doesn't have a spectator. And so a lot of these are very visual eye candy tricks, but then the rest of them that maybe would have a spectator, really all they're doing is maybe selecting a card or answering a question. You know, you're riffling through the cards and you just say stop. So you need them for that. But a lot of these tricks just work as little pieces of show that you are doing for them. And normally I would stick my negatives at the very end of the video. I'm gonna put them up here while we're still talking about the video. So the negative for me with this whole thing was just the access to the videos themselves, because I don't have a Magic Stream subscription. And if you don't either, you will only have access to view the videos. The only way you can get a chance or an opportunity to download the videos to own them physically on your hard drive would be if you had a Magic Stream subscription. All right, so what do they cover in the video? Well, he's gonna have an opening video where he talks about the history of how we got to this moment, right? And he's gonna do a little bit of introduction. Then he's gonna spend 2 minutes covering what's in the box. Then he's gonna spend about 8 minutes talking about some of the extra cards that aren't covered in the teaching. So there's maybe a handful of cards, maybe like 5 or 6, that don't have tricks necessarily assigned to them. But Lloyd takes that 8 minutes to explain how you could use that. So that's pretty good, because I think even Ultragaff, I think Ultragaff had like 10 cards or 11, or there's a lot of cards in Ultragaff that they never explained. They just kind of held them up and threw them off and said, oh, you could do this for this. And they didn't really tell you, and you felt like you got all these extra cards and you're like, what do I do with these? But with this video, you don't feel like any of the cards are unknown to you. Lloyd's gonna tell you exactly what each card does. Then the next video is about 11 minutes and Lloyd is gonna walk you through making the gimmicks. Now, don't think that there's a lot of arts and crafts with this, because there isn't. But there are, I think, 3 tricks that require a gimmick that you will need to build, and they're all the same gimmick. So once you learn how to build one, you know how to build the rest. You will need prim elastic in advance, I will say that. You'll need prim elastic and a needle. So if you're buying this, just go out to Amazon, buy prim elastic, make sure you have a needle at home so that you can finish building some of these gimmicks. And I would also recommend that you get some sort of a scoring template, like Perfect Score from John Allen. That'd be a good thing to have. That would help you with some of your lines, and maybe an X-Acto knife and a ruler to help you with some of the cutting on some of the other things. But like I said, none of the arts and crafts in this are difficult. Most of the gaffs won't require any arts and crafts at all. All right, so what are the tricks? What are the tricks, and what is he gonna cover? The first trick is called Vacuum. It's an ambitious card where you place the selection second from the top, and it continues to melt up through the top card in slow motion. Mirror Form is a card that reprints itself in reverse after you cover it with a mirror or a phone. Anniversary False is a trick where you show the Ace of Spades, but it has a hole in it. The spectator then selects a card, and then the two cards are fused together. Their card on one side, the Ace of Spades with a hole in it on the other, and then you're able to separate it even after they were examined. Stomach Punch is a trick with a queen, and she has a hole in the center, and then you restore it visually. In a trick called The Mutant, you have another card with a window in it, and through the window, the spectator is able to see one card transform into another. In the trick White Noise, you have a card with some barcodes on it, and you are able to shake the barcode and have it transform into a card reveal. In Box Through Card, the spectator is able to watch their cards slowly melt up through the box, and then you're even able to pull it out. Sand Card is a mentalism trick that you can do without a deck. You can have the spectator think of any random card, and then you visually make that card appear in your bare hands. In Double Zero, you punch holes into a card, and then lay that card against another card, and are able to heal the holes in that card and transform it into an impossible object. Sovereign is a really awesome trick that involves a coin. You pick a coin up off the table and place it onto the back of a deck, and then the spectator watches that coin visibly melt into the deck, and you are then able to reveal that coin back on the table. False Positive is a trick with an open tuck case. The back flap is folded all the way down, and with a wave of your hand, it becomes completely sealed once again. In Ode to Perseus, the card is selected and lost back into the deck. You then find their card, but then find it incorrectly. In Frustration, you rip the card into fourths, but then in a last minute attempt to solve the trick, you take one of the corners and transform it into a smaller version of their selected card. In Toe Shoes, a card is selected and lost back in the deck, and then the magician is able to almost pull back a window that allows him to see their card buried down in the deck. In King's Change, four random cards become four kings. In Hypno Queen, a regular queen transforms into a crooked queen just by having the spectator watch a spooky video. In Blackout, any card selected can be simply vanished and lost from between your hands. Vision is probably one of my very favorite tricks in this entire collection because it was inspired by 5x5, which is a trick I do all the time. You take a coffee stirrer and punch it through a dollar bill while it's housed inside of a card. And when the coffee stirrer is pulled out, the bill is seen to have no holes. Styrus is another trick with a coffee stirrer, and Lloyd takes it and melts it through a card visually right in front of the spectator. In Limbo is another sealed deck routine, but you start with an open deck, the flap fades shut and becomes a completely sealed deck, and then you're able to pull the cards out. Hurt is a really fun visual quickie. There's a card with a visible hole in it. You can actually see your hand through it, and in just a blink, it completely heals itself. And lastly, an original Acme appearing deck, the magician displays an empty box, and in a split second, it becomes full, and you can slide all the cards out. Like I said, massive collection, two decks, 23 tricks. Some of these you might even recognize from past performances that Lloyd has done on Instagram. So if you've been a fan of Lloyd's for a while or been following him on social media, I think you're gonna recognize some of these and be ecstatic that you're gonna learn the secrets. All right, so how difficult is this? What are the slides involved? What's the skill level on this? I would say these are doable. These are actually very doable. Most of the sleights, I would say the majority of them, 80% of them, are gonna be double lifts and palming. So if that's already in your wheelhouse, I think you're gonna be great with this. I think if you're gonna compare it to maybe other gaff projects in the past, this is way easier than Gamblers, okay? Way easier than Gamblers. And I would say this is even more practical than the original gaff system. Plus, I think with something like UltraGaff, in a lot of those tricks, you left the spectator staring at a gaff card, which I don't ever like doing. I kind of like the gaff card to come in as like a secret ninja weapon and then disappear. And that's how Lloyd's tricks work also. The spectator might see the gaff for a split second, but it's not the card that they're left with. And in some of the other gaff projects, maybe one trick had two or three gaffs in it and they were being rung in and rung out. In Lloyd's project, most of these tricks are only one. One gaff, that's all you need. One gaff that secretly does what it's supposed to do and then it's gone and then it's not part of the things that the spectator wants to inspect. All right, so I'm gonna answer one more question for you. You might be familiar with Lloyd and his work in the past, and you know that he does tricks on Instagram. So maybe you're thinking, well, these tricks probably only work on Instagram, right? This is only social media magic. Nobody would fall for this in real life. That's not true. Number one, the gaffs look incredible. They look absolutely incredible. The artwork on this is better than any other gaff deck I have seen in a really long time. Like sometimes when you see like a 4-on-1 card, you're like, that doesn't look real. Like that wouldn't look good in real life. These cards, they look really good. Plus, in the video, as he's doing the teaching, Lloyd addresses those concerns trick by trick. So he will always say, this is where your spectator should be for optimal viewing. This is where your lighting should be for getting the best out of this trick. He'll talk about performance area and venue for all these tricks so that you know exactly where and how to do these effects in real life. And one more thing I would say, yes, the deck comes with an extra set of cohorts, but buy another one. Like, in fact, there's actually red marked cohorts out there. There are red cohorts out there that are marked. So why not buy a deck of red marked cohorts? Then you'll have a fully marked deck that you could do crazy impossible things with, and then combine it with Lloyd's gaff system, and those two things together, you'll be blowing minds. All right, so is it worth your money? It's $40. $40 is insanely cheap. Yeah, it's everybody should get this. If you like it and you think this is something you'd like to do, I think you'll have a lot of fun with this. Like I said, the tricks aren't insanely hard. There's lots of tricks on here that require absolutely no skill level at all. You could probably do them with just a couple hours of practice and you'd have it down. You could start doing some of these tricks right away. Like I said, if you think you're already good with palming and double lifts, you'll be doing even more of these tricks right away. So yeah, thanks to Lloyd Barnes for helping me with some of my questions. And like I said, head on down to illusionist.com and pick one of these up. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.